Good morning. Welcome to the Oregon Fly Fishing Blog. Tony Torrence here. We're going to tie a series of trout patterns over the next few days. Hope you enjoy all these new flies. This morning we're going to tie a fox's pupae. It's kind of a neat little caddis pattern that I added to my box this year and produced a few fish. I bring my thread back to the back here. I'm going to tie in a little copper wire here and wrap my thread up all the way up, and then I'll get a little bit of, you can use, you know, the Vivas pearl. I'm just using a little flashaboo and pearl here for my underbody. I usually take two strands. Clip those and tie them in up behind the head. You want to get these tight together. Too much caffeine this morning. Hands aren't working. So I'll just wrap that in behind here and then get my wire out of the way. We'll start bringing the mylar back. This is an underbody. It gives a little flash before we add our ultra chenille. Come all the way back. Bring them back up together if you can. I got spread, but it'll be okay. Tie that off. I'm going to take some ultra chenille, and all you do is take the blue part of the flame and just kind of come in to create the taper. So I got the back part of the body tapered. I'm going to get it so it just goes beyond the bend of the hook. Tie this in. Now you can clip it first and then tie it in. I'm just going to do it this way for ease. Hold your body back in position. Come around with that first wrap and snug it down tight. Work your way forward. Now you can see that I've got a little bit of a slant on my body, and that's okay. I'll fix it. Got her all straightened out. I'm going to snug this down in here. I've got everything lined up. Now I'm going to put in a couple, I'm going to put in a hackle first. So you take your hackle, and I've got some partridge here. I'm going to get rid of these fibers at the bottom. I'm going to come back in here until I get where the fibers align a little bit. That's not a great feather, but it's going to work. And then I'll strip back some of those feathers out, cut the tip out, lay these back, and slide them in beside the body. And then pull these legs down on each side. There we go. And make a throat. Okay? Clean up all any little fibers on top. So now we have a throat of partridge in. We'll take a couple fibers of teal, use those for our antennae. Try to keep these together if you can and aligned where, see, so they both curve down. I'll lay this on top. Kind of put a loose wrap on there and pull this back into position. And if you did it right, they should both be kind of laying and cupped back there like that. Okay. This one's sticking up a little bit. That's okay. When I wrap the thorax in here, we'll be okay. So a couple strands of peacock and one strand of ostrich hurl. You can use a natural or a brown on the brown. I'm going to use some black. Trim them even. Tie them in. Then I'm going to take my hackle pliers and just bring these around. Just kind of build a little thorax in there. Snip that clean and then put a little whip finish and you have a fox's pupae.